رسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He's the only one worthy of praise. Seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The best of your ability, fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. Thursday, we usually talk about tarbiyah, cultivation. And inshallah, today we have a new chapter about tarbiyah, cultivation. And this about implanting the adab, the discipline, the behavior of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the future generation. We have tarbiyah, and we have means of tarbiyah, and we have the murabbi. The murabbi is the person who carry the job of bringing up the future generation, cultivating them, directing them, disciplining them. You call this person, he or she, you call it murabbi. Or murabbiya for female. This person that we call him al-murabbi, it can be the father, it can be the mother, it can be the teacher in the school, it can be the imam in the mosque, it can be the leader of the community. All those people, male or female, comes under the term of murabbi. That means they are qualified to be in the seat or in the position of a murabbi. Nevertheless, they are being voted for this position, or they've been selected for this position, but does not mean every one of those people can be qualified, because the murabbi himself have to have the proper training and the proper education and the proper tools to be able to bring up people to certain status. Nevertheless, those murabbi, those people who are supposed to be implanted and inserting the proper direction in the future generation and the youth, especially the early stage of youth. Those people have to be concerned about the tarbiyah of Islam, the discipline of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the Sahaba in general and the early and young Muslims specifically. Tarbiyah nowadays became so difficult and very serious job, because now more haram, more access and free interact with tools which can destroy the future generation by opening different channels, different means of communication, TV, DVDs, movies, internet. These things was not accessible to the people maybe 30, 40 years ago, as much as we see today. Maybe with internet exist, but was not for the common people to be using it. Maybe he found it there with the army and the intelligence people understand that carrying different things for the country. They have access to things like this, but today most of these things became available. And most of these channels, especially the cable and the TV, they did not produce anything good except few. Most of it is about music, it's about killing, fighting, movies,
games
and gays, and teach about nakedness, so-called freedom, expression of yourself. That means you can be walking with your pants almost going to your knees and your underwear is covered with your underwear. This for the man, but the woman is okay, she can show to a certain degree. So all kind of things, I'm sure that you will aware and you see it every day, everywhere. The parties, the clubs, all these things. So nowadays the tarbiyah, the discipline and the nourishment, the cultivation became very, very difficult, because you're trying to plant a apple tree in the middle of a whole field that full with thorns and snakes. Therefore, we need to go back again to what the Prophet ﷺ utilizing with the Sahaba, try to bring about a better environment, which is not easy. Even in the school is supposed to be a place for discipline and education, or education and discipline, but he found the school barely to be even a way of education. Some of the schools, they don't have enough teachers, or they don't have the upper teachers. And some of the schools, they understand, they add in different things to be part of education, which is not. So, returning back to the adab and the discipline and the behavior of the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is the only way that we can bring about a new generation, a better future for ourselves, our children, and those people who are going to inherit the deen after us. By reading the Quran and the authentic Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we find a lot of adab. In actuality, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as he told us, إنما بعثت لأتمم مكارم الأخلاق, أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, I had been sent to perfect or to complete the perfection of the adab discipline. By the way, there is no any prophet came before or any book been revealed before, unless you find a big part of it, it talks about akhlaq, manner, behavior, discipline, things like this. Islam came to collect all these things that came in the previous books and to add to it others and to perfect it and to make it in the best way. Reading the Quran and reading the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we found different adab. We can mention some of the names and the titles of it, that it needs to be utilized for discipline and cultivating the new generation. As example, the behavior and the proper discipline, communication with the parents, keeping the family ties, how to be a better host to your guest, show hospitality, the adab of dealing with the neighbors, the adab of seeking the knowledge and going after the useful knowledge, the adab of looking and staring about in the houses, the opposite sex, looking to certain things that you're not supposed to look, the adab of guarding the tongue and watching what you're saying, the proper adab and discipline concerning mixing, if it's men with men or women with women, or men and women being in the right, in the same place, how they're supposed to behave. So this is part of the teaching of Islam. The adab and the discipline of dhikr, remembrance Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The adab and the proper behavior of eating before and during and after. The adab of greeting, what to say, how to say, when to say, what kind of greetings that you use, the adab of hygiene and using the miswak, the adab of sneezing and yawning, seeking permission to come in or to leave, to talk, seeking permission in general, the adab of gathering when we sit in public places, when we sit in the mosque, when we sit in Khutbah al-Jum'ah, how we're supposed to behave, how we're supposed to act, where to sit, where we're not supposed to sit, all these things. The adab of traveling, going from place to place. A lot. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us about the importance of adab, that the most beloved ones among you to me, i.e. to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, أَحَاسِنُكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا, the most beloved one among you to me, the day of judgment, and those who will be the closer in destination to me, the day of judgment, those who have the best mannerism, the best behavior, the best discipline. This is a quick and general talk about cultivation and means of cultivation. Tonight, inshallah, we're going to take a small chapter, and this comes about the adab and the discipline with the parents. And let me clarify something here about discipline or behavior with the parents. You have to understand that it's very important in Islam because it comes immediately after the Tawheed of Allah and worshipping Allah, Allah alone. As Allah stated in Quran, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّهِ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And your Lord Almighty Allah had ordained that you worship none except Him and be good to your parents. Have ihsan, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Everything is hasan, everything is good in action, in talk, that you should have it with your parents. Especially living in America, and most of us, our parents, they are not Muslims. And some of us, they misunderstood this. Think because your parents are kuffar, that you go, you understand, and deal them in whatever manner because they are kuffar. Yes, they are kuffar, but their kufr is between them and Allah. You are not their God. Allah is the one who deals with them. So, being non-Muslims, you still have to treat them gently and nice and kind. To such a degree that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَإِن جَهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ فَصَاحِبْهُمَا فَلَا تُطَعْهُمَا وَصَاحِبْهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا. If they struggle with you or against you, that you associate a partner beside me, don't listen to them, but keep a good company with them. SubhanAllah. See the beauty of Islam. He's saying, even if they try to turn you away from Islam, don't listen to them and be good to them. So this is what we call in our language that you hold the stick from the middle. Okay? That you still have both opportunities. One, that you still have the Tawheed, and one, still have the good treatment to your parents. If they fail in their part, being a Muslim, this does not give you the right to be bad to them. Two wrong doesn't make right. In Surah Al-Isra, Surah Al-Isra, this is Surah, I think, number 17, verse number 23, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهِ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرُ إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا وَاخْفِضْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الذُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ وَقُلْ رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا. And your Lord Almighty Allah had ordained that you worship none except Him and be good to your parents. Especially if one of them or both of them reach the old age. Do not say off to them. Don't say any bad words to them. Not even expression of resenting or not disapproving. Okay? Don't say anything bad to them. And don't be harsh with them. And say honorable words to them. SubhanAllah. And lower your wing out of mercy for them. And say, O Allah, be mercy on them as they had raised me when I was a child or a baby. Your parents are still alive, you still can make dua for them. You are not losing anything, it's up to Allah, guide them or not. But don't be harsh. And there is nothing wrong for you to ask Allah to guide them. Okay? But if they die in kufr, after they die, it's too late now. You could not do anything about it. But dua, while they're still alive, acceptable. After they die, if they die in kufr, your dua is not going to help. Neither are you supposed to make dua for them. Because we don't know the future. So now by dying, now they already had determined their own future, so there is no way for them they can be Muslims. So now your prayer could not help, neither is supposed to pray for them. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him, he said, سألت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أي العمل أحب إلى الله عز وجل قال الصلاة على وقتها قال ثم أي قال ثم بر الوالدين قال ثم أي قال الجهاد في سبيل الله. Collection of Imam Bukhari رحمة الله عليه, reported from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Say, I asked the Prophet of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, which deed is more dearer to Allah, which deed and act that more beloved by Allah? So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, pray the prayer or perform the prayer upon its time. As soon as the prayer come, perform it. This is more dear to Allah than delaying it. 10, 15, 20 minutes, half an hour, 1 hour is okay, but you could not wait until the next prayer come. This is wrong. And this is not going to be acceptable if the other prayer enter. Okay? But if you get up and you prepare, you wash or you make wudu or take ghusl, whatever, and prepare for the salah, and after the adhan, maybe 15, 20 minutes, you make the salah. Allah loves making the salah early in its time. He said, O Prophet of Allah, what else or what comes after this? He said, being kind to your parents, having birr, having righteous deed towards your parents. He said, what else? He said, jihad in the cause of Allah. So the birr is a comprehensive term, which is the opposite of harshness and disobedience and being bad. So Allah, the Prophet ﷺ said what? Birr al-walidain, that kindness, gentleness, concern, doing anything good towards them, obedience to them. Part of being righteous and good to your parents is to spend over them when they, if they need. Okay? You take care of your parents. Especially if they are in old age, they could not make income anymore. You should be concerned about them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to keep their company in this life in a good term. And he said, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, and being benevolent to your parents. Part of righteousness towards the parents, respect, honoring them. Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with them, he saw two men. He said to one of them, who's that? Means the other man. He says, this is my father. He said, so do not call him by his name and do not sit before him. No, this is not in our dictionary here in America, in most cases, okay? But this is something very basic, adab, that the people even did not even teach it to their children, is automatically because the people, this, back home, this is the people, you want to call it even culture, still, it's part of adab of Islam. He said, who's this man? He said, this is my father. He said, okay, so you know this is your father? Never call him by his name. Okay? Say my father, my dad, whatever, but don't call him by his name. And do not sit before he sit. You will enter the house, you understand? You wait until your father sit first, and after this you can sit to show respect for him. Part of being kind and nice to your parents, to invite them to Allah, give them da'wah nicely, kindly. Imam Muslim rahmatullahi alayh reported that he heard from Abu Huraira that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam may Allah be pleased with him, that Abu Huraira saying, no one hear about me, a Christian or a Jew, hear about me unless he will love me. Why? He said, because Ummi, my mother, I used to invite her to Islam and she used to refuse. And I keep inviting her. So finally I went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, O Prophet of Allah, make dua for my mother that she will be Muslim. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua for the mother of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. So he said, after the Prophet made dua, I went back home and I see that the door is halfway closed. So, and I heard something going on there. He said, O Abu Huraira, indeed I had accepted Islam. So I went and I informed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said, O Prophet of Allah, make dua for me and for my mother. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the people love Abu Huraira and the mother of Abu Huraira. So anybody who hear about Abu Huraira or about his mother, they will love him. Out of being kind and gentle to your parents, seeking forgiveness for them, that if they die, that you make dua for them if they're Muslims, and that you carry their wishes, if it's something Islamically right, after their death. So if they said, I want you understand to do such and such thing, or I want you understand to go to visit your uncles, they are in the other state, things like this. So whatever wishes they have, if it's something good, and they die, that you should try to carry it. And this is part of being even good to them, even after their death. Also part of being good to your parents, to be good to those people who are related to them, or friends of them. Because it came in the collection of Imam al-Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi, that Ibn Umar, he said, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, inna min al-birri, inna min abarri al-birri salatu ahli waddi abih ba'da an yuwalli. Part of the righteousness, or one of the best ways of righteousness, is to keep in touch with those people whom that your father used to keep company with them or friends with them. And also being kind to your parents, that you pay their debt after their death. And if they did not get the opportunity to perform Hajj, that you will perform Hajj in their behalf, of course, after you make your own Hajj. The wife of Sanan ibn Salama asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and she told him that her mother passed away and she didn't perform the Hajj. Can I do Hajj in her behalf? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, yes. If your mother owes somebody money, are you going to pay the debt of your mother? She said, yes. He said, so you perform Hajj in behalf of your mother. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us that we act and behave with our parents as it's supposed to be, that Allah give us their pleasure during their life and their blessing after the death, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who carry their duty towards their parents, regardless of their life or death. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك إن الله knows best.